I'm late to the party here, but did you know that blue light is really bad for our health? And did you know that we receive a steady dose of blue light every time we use our electronics? Every time we look at our screens, blue light is penetrating our eyeballs. But good news, there's plenty of really easy and cheap things we can do to protect ourselves from blue light's harmful effects. First, let's start with what exactly the problem is. Because blue light is so bright, it makes a perfect backlight for LED devices like phones, tablets, laptops, and TVs, and of course, it's used in all of them. What recent studies have shown us is that this blue light inhibits the body's production of melatonin, which we all know is the hormone that helps us fall asleep. This is our body's natural way of making us sleepy before bedtime so that when we wake up, we're beautiful and refreshed and ready for another day. The problem is, our body understands the light from our monitors like it understands the light from the sun. Think about it. If you were to stare at the sun right before bedtime, your body's not going to release melatonin and prepare you for sleep. Likewise, if you're reading on your iPad before bed like I do, your body thinks you're staring at the sun and isn't preparing you for a good night's rest. But it gets worse. Melatonin doesn't just regulate our sleep cycles, it also affects our mood. Lower levels of melatonin could cause depression, obesity, heart disease, and even a couple kinds of cancer. Because melatonin is an antioxidant, it appears to play a pivotal role in slowing the progression of diseases. You get the point. Plus, sleep is not to be underrated. It's one of the pillars of optimal health, just as important as diet and exercise. You mess with my sleep and I'm not a happy camper. So the problem is, melatonin is important for your body. Staring at a screen disrupts the cycle and significantly affects your sleep. And sleep is extremely important to you as a human. Now at this point, I sort of feel dumb and naive for not paying closer attention to all of the studies going on about blue light. I go to yoga, I drink water, I try not to eat McDonald's, and now I find out that using my iPad to read at night is affecting my body and could speed up the progression of cancer? Even after Apple's recent night shift mode upgrade, I still didn't really pay attention to this problem. And I'm pretty sure part of the reason is because I don't like to think about having to protect myself from the technology that I love and use every day. I don't like to think about the fact that my technology might be hurting me. Now for the good news, there is good news. There are a lot of simple ways to combat the blue light problem and feel good about using your electronic screens in the evening. The solution. It's really simple and you have options. The easiest and most immediate thing you can do is download F.lux onto your computer. It's a program that tracks your daytime and evening hours and automatically filters your screen to display more warm colors in the evening and early mornings to help your body wind down at night so that you aren't staring into the sun at odd hours. Another thing you can do to help regulate the amount of blue light is wear protective gear. Blue light blocking glasses. If they're annoying or not fashionable enough for you, deal with it. Think of it like sunscreen. It's obnoxious, but completely worth it. Your health is way more important than any embarrassment you might feel from wearing orange glasses at night. And you'll love the better night's rest. Plus, sleep helps fight aging. So what would you rather have, wrinkles or amber glasses? There aren't that many reviews online for these glasses, but I included a few links to a few different brands down below that you can consider when looking for a pair. Lastly, another step you can take to help with the whole blue light problem is to buy some UV blue safe light bulbs, some amber light bulbs. I'm not exactly sure about the cost, but I've heard that they can be pretty expensive. But if you use them in the evening, they'll help set your circadian rhythm in place and improve your health. Fun fact, astronauts use bulbs to help regulate their sleep cycles on the International Space Station, so they do work. Well, that's all I really have for you on this. You better believe I'll be wearing my stylish safety glasses at night and enjoying my beauty sleep. But I'd love to hear your thoughts and suggestions about this topic. Maybe you've already taken these steps and have more tips for me. Let me know. Until next time, I'm Kelby with Penta Tech.